I'm Neil Thomas. I'm an academic in the School of Psychological Sciences. One of the main programmes of research which we have here at Swinburne is on the experience of hearing voices or auditory hallucinations. It's a type of experience which people may often report when they go to mental health services and might be something which they're seeking help around. The research which we're doing is about really trying to understand this experience better, not solely in people with schizophrenia, but across a range of different populations. And also, importantly, trying to find ways of helping people who have this experience in a persisting way and are distressed by that experience. Our research covers a number of areas. So one is around understanding what the experience of voices is like in different groups. One is using brain imaging technology to understand some of the mechanisms that are involved in this experience. The other is focusing on ways that we can help people, developing interventions for people. We've known for some time that generally speaking, seeing a psychologist for some sessions focused on trying to help people to manage their experience better is generally helpful. What we've lacked, however, is a real clear understanding about particular methods which might be most useful. Now, one of the challenges with that is that outside of specialist clinics like ours, that actually getting help from people about with these experiences can be fairly hit and miss. So without us knowing exactly what methods are most helpful, that can hamper some of our efforts to try and get interventions out there. One of the things, for example, that we're looking at is the use of mindfulness. So mindfulness has been used with a range of mental health problems so far. It's becoming quite popular. We see a particular application of this as a method for people with voices, because when someone is having the ongoing experience of hearing something, that it can be helpful for somebody to be able to focus their attention onto sort of away from the voices to help them to become less immersed in that experience. Where we see the real benefits of doing this research is in being able to inform practice in routine services. As part of what we're doing as well, we're linking up with some international collaborations whereby we're trying to understand the experience of hearing voices not solely as something associated with mental health problems, but as a broader experience as well. So doing some really interesting interdisciplinary research, thinking about how this experience has been come across in literature and art and so on. So, I mean, for instance, Charles Dickens spoke about how he would actually hear the voices of his characters coming to life. So we hear about this experience in ways which can actually be helpful for people and facilitative. And so if we regard this as a broader experience, we can maybe take from some of those understandings of this experience, which can also then in turn be applied for people that have real problems with this. There can still be a real fear about what mental health problems can be like, particularly when people have more severe, more complex mental health problems that are more outside of the range of our experiences of feeling sad, feeling anxious, and so on and so forth. What we know is that people that experience more severe mental health problems, such as schizophrenia, that group is much more likely to be victims of violence than to be perpetrators of violence.